pictures on my phone. Help me to pretend that I'm not alone. And you think I know better by now.
Oh, And welcome to what is the final round of season 20 of the Trophy Challenge. This is it. This is it, ladies and gentle ladies. We are about to go racing at Imola for what is the finale of season 20. And for once, the season isn't decided. Usually we get to this point and we kind of have an idea who's going to win, but it's not decided. It is not decided. Thanks for the gift, son. Appreciate the gift subs. All right, there was more than one. My voice is very strange and quiet. What? They're just gonna go forever now, aren't they? Helium voice? What? Have I pressed the button? No, I haven't pressed the button. Button? No button's pressed. There is something really wrong with your mic. Oh, that's not good. 1 minute. Let's try unplug it and plug it back in. Is that better? Yes, no, maybe. For my VTuber stream, yeah, that's it. VTubing. Is that better? Are we better now? Still a bit screwy? What? getting shafted. I'm getting shafted right now.
What? Right, let's try this. Is this better? Fixed? Okay. You can tell that I haven't actually joined the server yet, can't you? There we go. Let's see what's going on down at MLN. What's going down? Let's find out what's going down at MLN. Is there anything going down at MLN? It's still an echo.
All right, okay, let me try that.
Is that better? You like to Terry the kicks in the nuts? That's my normal voice. That's how I normally sound. I have to have loads of filters to sound like this. This is all filters. All of this is filters. None of it is actually my real voice. I have no idea what it sounded like before. I'm not a clue. Not going to lie. I ain't got a clue what I sounded like before. But yeah, this is my proper voice. It's okay, we found the eco. There are small Terry and helium Terry. Exactly, we're getting all the Terries, right? We are getting all of the Terries. Now, are we going to get some ACC? Yeah, there we go. I have to watch my own stream later to find out. Yeah, I do. Yeah, you're right. There we go. We got game. Look at that. It's very not beautiful game, but it's a game. I've literally just finished eating. So, don't come at me, okay, guys? Sorry. I've just finished eating. Literally got up here at 5:02. I had to log in and I was trying to set something up. But we're okay now. We're okay. I didn't even change the screen. No, it wasn't a kebab. It was steak. It was a big fat steak. Sorry, any vegans in here. But yeah. Emila. Where's Emila? There it is. I bet you didn't even notice that we had the background, the spa either. Who noticed that one? Who noticed it? Who noticed that it was spa instead of Emila? No eager eyes. No eager eyes in the chatties. Right, how many people have we got turned up? So, I mean, there was 43 signing. Okay, we got 40. We got 40 out of 43. That's pretty good going. You can't post a clip anywhere without getting a warning. Someone can permit you. I think there's you're too busy working on something. Yeah, so I was adding the info to the auto scroller, so you can basically with the new shop. There's a shop. With the new merch, what you can actually do is you can gift merch. Don't know how it works, don't ask me. But you can gift merch, and yeah, I had to set it up just in case someone wanted to do it. There's no merch command yet, so I need to add that. But yeah, there you go. That's what I was doing, if you must know. Hello, everyone. How are you? Are you ready for the finale of season 20? We do have a bunch of giveaways to give away, by the way. So yeah, sorry about that. I can't remember how many Guild setup subs we have to give away, to be honest. So I'm going to take like 5 names or something and hope I can give you all a Guild setup sub. I should probably just check here. I'll just go check. It'll be easier. I know we've been missing out on them, so I'm gonna go check them. I'm just search me inbox. Is Twitch gifting? Yeah, I don't know how it works. You can buy gifts for people. I don't know how it works. I don't know what button you click or where you go, but yeah, it exists. Right. Okay. So we have. Right. I got one. Right, okay. Let me gift a secret. I don't know how it works. Right, so we got 5 subs to go set up to give away. I've already given away one, so we got 4 to give away on this stream. All right, okay, that makes sense. So what we'll do is we'll just add a giveaway thing. So all you have to do is... Where is it? Giveaways. Here we go. Set the image for the thingy. Let me get Go Setups uploaded. Oh my god, I haven't got ghost setups uploaded. This is what you have to deal with when you know you mean you got to set it all up as you go along because you don't have time during the day. So you gift a secret item. So yeah, I don't know how the gifting works via the merch, but yeah, it exists. It exists. Aston gang in the house. Yeah, there's an uprising. I've seen an uprising of GT4s and Astons lately. I don't know what's been going on, but yeah. I think that's the Aston gang for Imola, right? Go represent Scottish, man. Let's see who's out there qualifying. Anyways, I have put it on auto director. So there you go. Thanks for the sub. Appreciate it. I'm trying to get all of the stuff. There it is. Thanks for the race. Oh, no worries. No worries. Hey, thank you for tuning in. Thank you for tuning in. How do giveaways work on here? Ticket cost. Yeah. Great start. So ticket. Oh, it's ticket. Exclamation mark ticket. There we go. There you go. So you can buy as many tickets as you want. It's based on your points for stream elements. So it's just exclamation mark ticket. You get yourself in the giveaway. Your first ticket's free. There you go. If you want all the information, it's here. There you go. We have a total of 4 Go Setup subs to give away in the Twitch chat, and then we'll give the rest away to the drivers. It feels weird now being a white number plate driver. Well, there you go. There you go. Exclamation mark ticket. Man. Exclamation mark ticket. And then you'll get entered into... That's question mark ticket. I said exclamation mark ticket. At least I'm sure I did. Ticket 1000. Too much hash exclamation mark. Question mark work. Yeah, it is. Daily. Oh man, you're doing it all wrong. You're doing it all wrong. No, but yes, you can get yourself involved in the giveaway that way. And yeah, get a free Go Setup monthly sub. There's 4 months to give away. 4 months to give away, so we'll do the draw and we'll see how many people win. Easy peasy. By S-Class. Ah, I see how it is. It's the end of the season. You're all gonna come down on me. I see how it is. You have earned 198 Terry coins. Come back in there now. Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. I think you can do like exclamation mark giveaway and stuff like that. I think you can do exclamation mark commands and see them all, to be honest. If you want to do it the easy way. Apparently there's a race going. Apparently, I think everyone's just in this chat to where... Ah, you can exclamation mark enter or giveaway. Giveaway might help. There we go. Or is there already a giveaway? Oh, there already is. I can add loads of commands. There. Yeah, knock yourself out. There you go. There you go. All the tickets. All the tickets. I think I might have broke it. Holy tickets. Holy tickets. Did I break it? 1 minute. Try exclamation mark giveaway. Maybe? Failed to enter. Ah, there we go. Okay. The ticket works. Ticket works. It's ticket. It's ticket, not tickets. That's why. Okay, we're good. We're good. We're good. I think there was actually a max you can set on the giveaway. So one sec. One minute. I will update it and you can buy as many as you want. Can I actually set the settings? Okay, yeah, I can. No, I can't. No, apparently you can only buy 20 tickets. Okay. Is it including mods? No, everyone can enter. One minute. Refund it, and then let's go again. Yeah, there was a maximum. All right, maximum tickets per user. I'll put it to like, how many guys? How many tickets do you want to buy? 1,000? 10,000? I'll just put 99999. 1,000. 100. I'll put 100. They are for the giveaway. One minute. Right, okay. How many tickets should we go up to? It'll sell you. There we go. What's the giveaway for? There you go. 69 should be a limit. It's like 1,000 though. You'll be right. You'll be fine. There you go. Exclamation mark ticket. You can get yourself in the giveaway. Job done. Easy peasy. Sorry about that. It's going that fast, the bot can't keep up with you. There you go. Look at it. You're spamming it. You don't have enough points. There we go. That's better. Mental. Anyways. It's the number of how many tickets you buy. And it's 20 a ticket. What, you're trying to win? It says on the... There was actually a command, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Whoa. No stream elements. Bad stream elements. That's not what we're giving away here. We are not giving that away. That's false advertising. That is false advertising, that. That's false advertising. Let's try this again. Huh? You don't work? Okay. Thanks for the Steam voucher. I know, right? I don't know. See, it says it's meant to work, but, Anyway, subscribers get, I think like two times as, yeah, there you go. You get like two times chance or something in it. So if you're a subscriber, please. There you go. I'll just ticket and ad work. I know, right? Maybe. No? Okay. Screw it. Give in. Right, let's actually have a look at what qualifying is going on since the actual qualifying started. So Felix currently on pole position in the... Look at the Astons. Wagwan here then. Casper's in an Aston. Thomas Perello's in an Aston. Felix is in an Aston. Look at all the Astons. Look at this. Felix is currently on pole. Thomas Perello in second, and Casper Johansson currently in third. So if you go by the silver in the AM qualifying, the balance performance is absolute jank. But let's have a look at the pro qualifying, because these are the drivers that are either in A class or and have a high pit skill rating. So we're going to find out what sort of qualifying times they can put in. Remember that current champion is this, not this man. It is, where is he? There's this man. This man right here is the current champion of the series. I'm just waiting for all the subscribers to lay off. Thank you all subscribers that are just joined. Appreciate it. Appreciate all the new subs, all the new follows, and all that beautiful stuff. Appreciate it all. Who is the bestest? Another sub. I'm just waiting for them all going.
They have given 27 gift subs in the channel.
Don't forget that the race sensation NL, .NL, rather. Imola, not Fundurance. I was about to say Fundurance because that's what we always used to run, right? But we're not running a Fundurance. It's a proper endurance. 6 hours of Imola on Saturday. It will be streamed. It won't be streamed by me. We will have Alex, who used to stream the Weekend Warriors, back, as well as Owen Huxtable. Owen Huxtable will be on the stream. So you can get yourself involved in that. Andrews, there's still sign up positions available, as well as it will be commentated and live streamed. It will be on this channel, as it always is, if we are streaming it. But yeah, you can get yourself involved in that still. All the information in terms of the actual event itself is in the Endurance Special Event Series. Return of Owen. Return of Owen. Owen's back. Owen is back once again. The Renegade Master. You can read all about that Endurance Series there. For some odd reason, it added a bracket on. I didn't need to be there. But yeah, you can read all about that Endurance Series there. There is prizes available for the drivers in that series. But Owen and Alex will be streaming that. I won't be involved in the streaming of that. I'm sadly busy this weekend. To be honest, Wednesday is a bit of a push for me right now, but we live and live. Ben Avrod, currently not anywhere near pole. Reese Tattersall, though. Reese Tattersall, currently in third place, looking to get that qualifying time down. Isn't up where Felix is just yet. There's Ben Avrod in the number 29, currently in fourth place position. He's going to be looking to make sure he qualifies ahead here. He doesn't want any of that Formula One style fun in in Imola. He should have picked the Aston. I mean, you pick the car where the person's doing the bop in it, right? That's the key, right? I need one of these, but in pit skill format. Don't we? That's it. Ethan, is there the ability to have a water bottle with Pitsco logo on it? That's the real question. Yeah, literally, whatever Felix drives you pick, because Felix is doing the bop. It's totally favored that way. Let's find out if Ben Avrod can go faster, though. Can he get it any higher than fourth? No. Going across the line. Across the line and still fourth. Reese Tattersall in third. Can Reese Tattersall go faster? You can get a Pitsco water bottle. Well, you know what I'm getting. You know what I'm getting from the merch website. A nice Rebston joined in the end. Yeah, he's currently in sixth position, though. Obviously, going to have to improve his qualifying time to challenge the top of the pack. Now, you got to remember, Felix is kind of quite quick. But, I mean, these Astons seem pretty quick. Let's find out if Reese Tattersall can kind of throw the viewer bias away from that, though, because it's not too great right now. Casper isn't quick. No, you're right there. Casper's slow. I mean, he's nearly a second behind everyone else, so. That's fine. Hello, Jake. All right, Reese is going to go across the line. Ben Avrod looking to try and get himself onto pole. Let's find out if he can do it rather on board of the Ben Averod. Averod and Strident Racing Forever. Am I going to join the NLS races if I have time? I'm hoping. I'm already signed up for the 1st of April event. So yes, I'm hoping to race in the 1st of April event. Hey, it does work. Good bot. Well done, bot. There you go. Now let's find out as Averod goes across the line here. Will he get this any higher than 4th place position? And around the bend and across the line, and he goes into... Well, he's still 4th. Still 4th. He just can't do it. He just hasn't done it yet. I realised the start-finish line was a little bit earlier than that. Luke about to cross the line. Where is Luke going to finish? He is going to finish, well, currently in 6th. He's got 2.5 minutes to go to try and... 5th, rather, to try and close down the gap. I was saying 6th because Rebston is currently in 6th. Let's see if he can close down the gap to the top of the field. Currently 6th coming through that final chicane. Down the hill he goes in the AF Corsa 106. So this is going to be a fantastic race. A lot of these drivers will have already done like loads of practice for the 6 hours of Imperial event. It's exclamation mark tickets to get yourself involved in the giveaway. Tickets. So Rebston qualifying 6th still hasn't been able to improve on that time. Resets are looking to do so, however. Still has to come through the... I'm trying to figure out where... Oh, he's only just started his lap, actually. Looks like he's lost a lot of time in Sector 1, actually, because he's gaining quite a bit of time here. He is gaining quite a bit of time. It's quite cold here at Imola. 16 degrees in the air, 18 degree track temp. It's not the warmest of tracks. It is 9 o'clock in the morning, so we'll allow them off. And more giveaways? And you're just going to hear... Wow. Wow. DL underscore Don 27. Are you trying to start hype train for the final race of the season? I think Don's trying to start hype train for the final race of the season, guys. I think he is. Even though he's hyped that Reese Tattersall is about to possibly smash ball. Possibly. Could be done. Oh, there we go. Okay. Now the hype train's close. I thought you were just trying to get the hype train close, but it's getting there. It's getting there. Getting there. Only a few more bits or subs. Anyways, Reese Tattersall about to cross the line, about to possibly take pole. Let's see. As he goes across the line, does take pole, knocks those Astons down a peg, and the BMW is currently king of qualifying right now in the first place position on pole. Ben Averod not able to do so. Ben Averod, the current championship leader, is going to be starting in 4th. He's not going to have enough time for another qualifying lap. That is going to be it for Ben Averod. Let's see if Luke Tranmere can actually knock him back a bit. There's also Rebston, the wild card for today's race, possibly could be able to knock Ben Averod back as well. But Ben Averod in a very, very bad qualifying position for him right now. Currently in 4th, Reese is already trying to put that car to the floor. He's trying to find a little bit more time in that BMW. Luke out there getting a draft off of... Who is that car ahead of him? The number... Thierry. Thierry, who's currently in 12th, and he's getting a draft because Thierry isn't actually on a valid lap. So we're going to find out here if Luke can get that draft and will get to go across the line. Here we go. Luke across the line in 5th. Will he go up to 4th? No. Stays in 5th. He stays in 5th. Reese Tattersall looking at Thierry Henry, possibly. Reese Tattersall looking to improve on his time where he is right now. I mean, you can't really improve on pole, but you can improve the time, can't you? Let's find out if Reese Tattersall can do so. Across the line, he's about to go. Across the line, he does. And one, it's still a 139.7. So 139.787 is the pole time. We need a new Twitch sound. Yeah, I know, right? Pop it in. I'll tell you what. If you think we need a new sub noise or a new follow noise or anything like that, yeah, pop it in the Discord. There's a PSI or Twitch channel thingy on there. Pop it in there. So where has everyone qualified? Well, let's have a look at the table. So Restat's all in first. You can see that balanced performance in play there. Restat's on first. Felix in second. Third is Pirello. Fourth is Avarod. Fifth is Tranmere. Sixth is Wildcard Rebston. Seventh is Busso. Eighth is Wildcard Johansson. And ninth is Tad. Followed by 10th Pollock. What's it? That is actually rather interesting, to be honest. But let's have a look at the standings as they go into this race. There's Ben Avarod and Reese Tatsall. Very, very close. So the fact that Reese Tatsall has qualified four positions ahead of Ben Avarod is mega, really. It is absolutely, absolutely mega that it is that much of a distance, because this might be the race where Reese Tattersall manages to actually take the win from this might be the race that Reese Tattersall actually manages to take the win from Ben Avarod. But let's start a prediction, right? So who's gonna win the race? Well, it won't be Sergi. Let's put Felix is already in there. Tell you what. Have you just started a hype train while I've been trying to do this? There you go. You could put your predictions in on who is going to be winning the race. You get some points back. You can't put them in the giveaway. You can use them on the stream. But you can predict there who is going to win the race. Will it be Ben Avarod? Will it be Reese Tattersall? There you go. You guys decide who already. You've got 10 minutes to get your entries in. You've got 10 minutes to get your entries in. But whilst you do that, what we're going to do is we are going to go down the grid for the final time this season and have a look at all of the beautiful liveries on display. There's Reese Tattersall qualifying in pole position. Felix, second place position in the Aston Martin. Thomas Pirello in third place position in the 712 Aston Martin. And actually, Felix is 217. Pirello is 712. That's interesting. That Ben Avarod in fourth in the number 29 Lamborghini, currently sat in first place position in the championship. Will he be able to take the win here at Imola and claw his way back from fourth place and be able to take the championship? If he finishes, if Reese finishes anything higher than third, he might be in a good chance for clawing this championship back. But Luke Tranmere in the 276 McLaren in fifth place position. He is on those predictions for you, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies, let's see what he can do. Looks like the wins and you're a bit spread out. Rebston currently in sixth place position. He could be able to claw some positions back for you here. 106 if you're looking for that number on the timing screens. Busso GT in the Bentley 360 currently in seventh place position. Kasper Johansson in eighth place position in the number 24 Aston Martin. Tadeus in ninth place in the 699 McLaren. Alexander Pollock in the 132 Porsche in 10th. Manuel Antrax in 11th place position in the 388 Ferrari. Keep your predictions coming in on who is going to finish where. Andrea Thierry in 12th place position in the number 46 Lexus. Jude Neville in the 128 AMG in 13th place. Kenny Crowe starts 14th place in the number 93 with a massive Sigma on the front. Look at that. That's beautiful. Balage starting in 15th in the 369 Audi. Ben Lopard starting in 16th in the Aston Martin. Luciano in 17th in the 1-2-3. Mecca in 18th in the 1-3-3. Fredriksson starting 19th. And Svoboda starting 20th. They're coming up to the final chicane. So here is the rest of the grid. There is Williamson, Thomas, C. Law, Molinier, Jansman, Demua, King, Pitley, Scotland, Perry, Lawson. We then have Filman, Fisher, Slurink, Nitro, Putman, Kano. I'm not entirely sure who this guy is because it's concatenated his name. Tador, rather. David Little, and then Karim. Karim. Right then, back to the front of the grid, and they are lining up here at Imola, and we are about to go green under the gantry for the final time in season 20 for the Go Setups Trophy Challenge. And Reese will be starting on the outside line in pole position on the left hand side. And it's a long way down. And we go green under the gantry. Reese Tattersall getting ahead quickly there. Felix already nipping in behind him. You can see one of the Ferraris, I think that's Rebston, on the outside line trying to get away around. Luke gets a little bit of a bump with championship leader Ben Averill. Ben Averill just drops right down the pack, and there is a big old kerfuffle in the first chicane, but that allows for Felix to get himself into first place position. Reese Tatsall now in second. The front pack is now Thomas Pirello in third place position. Alexander Pollock in fourth. Reese Tatsall needs a really clean race here, and the championship has, as you say, been blown wide open because Ben Averill is all the way down in 30th place position. He is going to be looking to get himself back into this race, get himself back into the points, but Felix is battling hard here to hold on to first place position. Reese Tattersall in second. Thomas Pirello third, and followed by Alexander. Reese is already looking to try and make up that position, get himself back into first place position. No, that number 42 is already all over the back of Felix. Does not want to leave that car behind in the start of the race. And let's just see how that has worked out for the timings. There you go, ladies and gents. You can see already that those timings are a little bit all over the place, aren't they? So who has gained the most from that? Luciano up 7, Pollock up 6, Law also up 6, but the big losses are Ben Averill, who's dropped all the way down to 27th. Luke is now in 28th. Svoboda down into 30th, and that is a big drop for the championship leader. The championship leader is going to be looking to claw his way back up this pack. Sadly, we can't actually find out what happened to it, because you know what happens when I click that button. We wait 10 minutes for the game to sort itself out. But Felix in the lead in the Aston Martin, being able to pull ahead here, and is currently gaining time away from Reese Tattersall. Yeah, I'm going to fix it for next season. Don't worry about that. We are going to fix it for next season. It's because I enabled like ultra textures on deliveries. So whenever we run deliveries and it goes back, it absolutely chunks it. But yeah, Reese Tattersall currently in second. You see him right on the back of Felix already. Does not want to leave the Aston Martin. The BMW, we know, has the qualifying pace. Does it have the race pace here in Imola, though? We already know that Felix has at least one track cut warning. You can see right now how close Reese Tattersall is catching to the back of Felix, looking to maybe pressure him up the inside here on the back of Felix as he comes through the back chicane. Felix going to a little bit squirrely as he just gets that car a little bit unsettled. But this pack at the front is very close-knit already. There's not a second gap all the way down into 10th place position. Imola is bringing the racing, and Felix is trying to hold on to first place position. Yeah, Luke had a little bit of an off, and I think it all spiraled downhill from there. And currently, the championship leader is down in 25th position. So he's going to be looking to make sure he is... looking to make sure he's actually going to close down the gap. You want to see a POV? All you have to do, as you've done, Get an onboard lap. Oh, that onboard lap. Let's race on board with restarts all in as he tries to close down the gap. It looks like there's actually a yellow flag. Sorry, one second. There's a yellow flag of Mecha. It looks like he's going to be back on the track, though. Tadeus has lost a couple of positions because Busso is fighting for those positions. Rebson's just had a little bit of a scratch and a bump with Busso there. And Busso's trying to find his way back. Don't worry, we will get back to restarts all at some point. We'll use your points up. Do not worry about that. But you can see here, Busso right on the back of this fight for seventh place position. Let's see if Manuel Antrax and Jude Neville can find out who's going to be coming out ahead of this one. Jude Neville's currently in seventh place, currently holding on to that seventh place position as well. But Antrax is all over the back end of him. So is Busso. Busso is looking to get that car nice and personal up close. And you can see already, well, we're going to find out just how close Busso can get it. In the Bentley, there has been another yellow flag, and this is another battle all the way down the back. But King is off. Fredrickson is now in 17th, and look at these cars as they come into the final chicane. All too wide all the way back. Positions are going up and down. Ben Avrod's in this pack. Ben Avrod, the championship leader, is in this. He's up in the 21st, looking to possibly get ahead and get himself into... this is the battle for 21st, so Ben Avrod just ahead. Pitley battling him out, though, for the 21st place position. Ben Avrod is making his way back through the pack, and it looks like one of the drivers actually coming in early there. That is Mecha, the 133 car, coming in early. Ben Avrod's trying to find a way back up this pack. But the championship leader swap, because Reese Tattersall... This is hard to keep up with, guys. Reese Tattersall in first place. Kasper Johansson's off. With Balazs, I think Kasper and Balazs had a little bit of a rub, but Reese Tattersall has been able to take hold of first place. Felix just wasn't quick enough to manage to hold off. This is just absolutely crazy. Alexander trying to get into this battle, though, has to get past Pirello, the 712, to close down onto the 217. That is what we are looking at. The battles. Where is Avrod? Avrod currently 19th. He's got a bit of time to close down the gap to 18th, though. He's closing down the pack. He is finding his way. Now, I remember Manuel Benz having a little bit of a spin once at Imola, and he managed to climb his way back up the pack. I don't think he got the win, but he was really close. He was really close to closing his way down the pack. Let's find out if Reese Tattersall can win. I don't think he won. I think he came second. He might have won. Someone can correct. Oh, Ben Avrod's off. Ben Avrod is off again. No, Ben Avrod is off again. And he's behind Balazs. He's down in 23rd. I think he went off on his own. No one was really near him at that point in the track, I don't believe. But yeah, Ben Avrod jumping over the curbs, and I can't replay. I can't replay, guys. Sorry. Pitley in 20th. And Pitley. That's not how you want to see Balazs or Pitley's race ended. That is, yeah, that's not good. That's not good. But Ben Avrod got through there okay. Ben Avrod got through there okay. Fisher is looking to challenge the championship leader for 20. I don't know what's going on in this race anymore, guys. I do not know what's going on in this race. Thierry's just managed to take hold of 10th place position past Luciano. Mind is blown. Demure is now up into 23rd. Pirello is on the back of Felix. I'm watching a game of COD Search and Destroy. I think it's a game of CS, to be honest. I think they've been watching the majors too much. Pirello right on the back of Felix or the Invitator. I don't know what was playing. You can tell me what was playing. Pirello right on the back of Felix here. The Aston on Aston battle going on for second place position. Maybe we'll just sit on the air at the top five because the racing was a little bit more predictable. But yeah, the Aston Martin cruise control missile. Cruise missile? I don't know. We'll figure some out. Pollock on the back of this battle though, going into the chicane. We're going to find out if Pollock can find a move. Can he? No, doesn't. Decides not to in the first chicane. Avrod is now battling Scotland for 19th place. Yes, he is battling the whole of Scotland right now, and he's managed to take 19th from them. He is up against the whole of Scotland. Anyways, Nathan Williamson, in 13th, currently losing out position to Law, and Jeremy Thomas caused a yellow flag ahead. Looks like it's all cleared up, though. I'm trying to get to him as quick as I can. Ben Avrod up into 19th, has managed to retain that position away from Avrod. Lawson off in number 52 car here. Just get himself back onto the track and off the racing line. But yeah, let's see if Ben Avrod can close down the gap to the top, though, because he's currently 30 seconds behind Reese Tattersall. 30 seconds is the gap from 19th to first place position. And Ben Avrod is, yeah, I think Balazs is dead. And Ben Avrod is going to be looking to close down that gap. Obviously, he does actually have a drop round in third to lose, but I don't know how many points Reese Tattersall is going to gain from this race. So if Reese Tattersall gains a lot more than Ben Avrod's third place position that he dropped, and it's enough to close down that gap as well, very, very possible that we might be seeing this Reese Tattersall actually winning the first trophy that's actually gone to a UK member. That's quite interesting. Because the only three people that have ever won, two people that have ever won since the trophy was in the championship is Manuel Benz and Ben Avrod. Ben Avrod's won it twice, and Manuel Benz won it three times, I believe. So Reese Tattersall might be the first in the UK to actually win a pit school trophy. Yes, that is correct, ladies and gentlemen. That is the first time that possibly Reese could win the trophy and take it home for the UK. But Felix is going to be saves on the stream. Yeah, go and hand deliver it. So, to be honest, if he's going to karting, so we're planning on doing a community meetup later in the season. I could bring it to karting. That would be ace, actually. I get to present it myself. Get the confetti cannons too. Go all out. Avrod's off again. Oh, no, he's not. Okay. Jansman had the yellow flag, not Avrod. Avrod just got past him. I was like, what again? This does not, should get a t-shirt with too. Actually, we could do t-shirts. I think it's actually cheaper to do a t-shirt now than it is to do a trophy. Get a shipping cost in the UK because it goes in like a, it doesn't go like in a normal, like you can't just send it in a normal box, obviously. It costs like quite a bit. It costs like nearly as much as the trophy to send it. It's mental. Crazy. But it's only one, so it's not too bad. Right, let's have a look at the redemptions then. So we've got an onboard lap of the number 42. I know we're not going to get any battles from him, but you can at least get on board of the current race leader. Looks like Casper, the number 24, has caused a yellow flag. Dropped down in 22nd place position. I bet Casper was like, I'm really good at Imola. I mean, as far as I know, he's been practicing quite a bit at Imola. And yeah, he's just had a spin-a-rooney. So poor Casper. Gets himself in the trophy challenge for the first time. And he did this for pit rep, did he? All right, fair enough. Yes, to be fair, it's a good race for pit rep. 60-minute race, a lot of corners. And yeah, he's caused yellow flags every four laps. No, I'm joking. I'm joking, Casper. Yeah, onboard lap of Reese Tattersall done. Let's have a look at Scotland now. Where is Scotland? Well, there's yellow flag back here. It's for border and King off the track. Where's Scotland? We still got Scotland. There's Scotland. Currently holding off Jansman for 18th place position is Scotland. That's a flappy bonnet Aston, is it? No, it looks okay. Unless there's a different Aston. Is there a different Aston? Is it Casper's? Oh. Casper's not even got... Ooh. That's rough. Yeah, that's rough. Casper is increasing in incidents per corner rating. Luciano's had a yellow flag. A little bit slower. What pit rep is he gaining? Minuses. Minuses is what Casper's gaining today. Nathan Williamson getting himself involved in the battles for 13th place. He's actually technically the battle for 11th. Lopard is leading this train. And he's got six carriages currently, technically. If you include himself, but he's got five carriages behind. That's Law, Fredrickson, Tarje, Fredrickson, Williamson in 14th. 15th is Thomas, and 16th is Ben Averod. So this is actually Averod's, what actually could be a great points fight for Averod, and he possibly could get himself up close and personal to Jeremy Thomas's Lamborghini here. As we see them all get by Nathan Williamson. Three cars in one corner. That's a bad, bad breaking point for Nathan Williamson. He's just missed out on that. Bad breaking point from him. Too early on the brakes and allowing nearly everyone by. Ben, he's just lost out on every single position in this train. Every single position in this train. That is a big F for Nathan Williamson there. Big F indeed. Bad corner for Nathan gang. Is that just a globally bad corner for Nathan's, is it? Yeah, here is Ben Averod currently in 15th, looking to close it down on to Jeremy Thomas. You saw him battling him out earlier before. And yeah, there is a battle going on between Rebston and Tad. Rebston's just managed to get it up into 15th place. Oh, yep, just does get it through that corner. I thought it might have been a rough and tumble. Ben Averod's managed to get it past Jeremy Thomas as well. It seems like everyone is passing at the same time. Florent Demure up into 20th. So Rebston now in 5th. He's managed to get in a position. Tadeus in 6th. Ben Averod's up to 14th. Felix is now 4 seconds away from Restart Soul. 4 whole seconds away from Restart Soul. Restart Soul currently sat holding on to first. Ooh! Merch and Patreon at the same time. That's, oh wait, hang on. No, I think that's just, that was just, yeah, that was, okay. Okay, it just give two things at once, didn't it? That's fine. Where's Balazs gone? Balazs is currently right at the back of the grid. I don't know whether he's actually still in the race. No, he isn't. No, he isn't. Yeah, Balazs retired, sadly. Pirello holding on to third place position. Remember that giveaway is still open. 16 entrants so far and 727 tickets. 727 tickets. Wow. Wow. That's a lot of tickets. That is a lot of tickets. Where do we think Ben will climb back up to? It's a good question. Fredrickson is currently battling with Law, though, the 140 BMW. And Fredrickson looking to close down that gap, get that position. Currently sat in 13th. This is the battle for 12th. Does get a good run here, though, and actually gets it by. Fantastic bit of racing from Tarje. Great bit of racing from himself up into 12th. And Ben Averod is going to be the next person to try and get it past Law. He's closed down around about 11 positions, I believe, from the start of the race. So good fight back so far. Hopefully don't commentators curse that. But yeah, Ben Averod currently fighting his way back up the grid from 25th. I think he dropped to was the lowest. So definitely looking to close down those gaps. Manuel Antrax on looking for a pass on the back of Jude Neville. Doesn't manage to get it done, though. And contact between the two, both facing the wrong way. This might be great for Averod because he's currently closing down onto that. And see Law ahead. And that spin is just ahead of this. Have they managed to get themselves going before Ben Averod gets there? Yes, they have. But that is going to close down that gap. That time drastically. That is going to close down that time drastically to those cars ahead. As we see Averod looking to kind of shake a move. Shake a move. See if he can find a way past Law. Round the outside. Possibly around through the left-hander. Here we go. Ben Averod. Can he get it done? Does he have the power in the Lamborghini? Tries to get his power down early. The back end just kicks out. And not enough there from the Lamborghini to get past that BMW. As we go through the left-hander though, it's going to be a fast turn through here. This is a good passing opportunity if you can get it done early enough. And yeah, there we go. Ben Averod getting late on the brakes and getting by Law there. Now he's going to be looking to lay down the Law onto Tye Fredriksson. Pirello currently in third. And Pollock's in the pits early. Pollock is in the pits early. Busso's going to be able to take that position as well. And Fredriksson is now going to be leading a free car train. Law should have defended harder. He is Reese's mate. Ooh, stickers. Wow, there you go. You can even win yourself some stickers. All you have to do is press exclamation mark, enter, and you can get an actual sticker delivered to your house. An actual sticker. That's not like fake. That's an actual sticker. So you got exclamation mark, enter, and yeah, get an actual sticker. No, it's not a Hall or Terry. I should do that, shouldn't I? I should get myself an actual... Should we get a Terry Kappa face? We should do that, shouldn't we? We should do that. But yeah, we got holo stickers on the store. Actual holo stickers, like the shine and stuff. Need to blame Terry holo? Yeah, I know, right? We can get that. We can get Terry Kappa holo as well. To be honest, after this race, there you go. Invader Rod has just won it. You can go redeem it and get it. 5 pending items for me to prove. Jesus. Opie and box a gold sticker. There you go. You can log in with Twitch and redeem your sticker. Nice and easy. Look at that. Beautiful. Free gifts. I don't even know how you managed to do that. I was trying to read how you actually give it away. I think you like buy it and then gift it or something, don't you? So yeah, you can give away actual proper items now. Jude Neville on the back of Andre Tielli, looking for 7th place position. Ben Averod's right on the back of Fredriksson here, though. Look at how close he is to the back bumper of the number 92. Around the outside, he looks to go, but Tye late on the brakes. Well, not late on the brakes, but carrying that braking speed through. But Ben Averod does manage to get ahead into 10th. It charges you for the shipping? I think it charges the winner of the giveaway for the shipping, and it charges you for the actual sticker, I think. But that's how it works. So if you win it, you just have to pay shipping. You paid the shipping? All right, okay. Fair enough. But yeah, Ben Averod around the inside of Luciano there. That's a backmarker. That is blue flagged at number 34th place position. 1, 2, 3, backmarker. The sticker's £8. To be fair, it's a holo sticker. The thing is, basically the way it works, the more people buy stuff, the cheaper stuff gets. Eventually. So yeah. It works. It works. But it's just the way we have to do it. It's kind of, you know. You get some free swag and you get some supporters at the same time. So, you know. Well, it's not free. You know what I mean? You get some swag and you get some supporters at the same time. So, just the way it goes. But yeah, Jude Neville. Currently on the close down to 200 Thierry. You got a switch to the 1-2-1 of Alex Perry. Another Aston Gang. Is this... Yeah, it could be delivered anywhere in the world. Yeah, you're right. Especially on the Twitch stream as well. Like, the amount of people that could be watching from anywhere in the world. I do have a wonder. How many people in here are driving the 6 hours of Imola? How many people are driving the 6 hours of Imola at the weekend? It's on Saturday. How many is there entered into it? If you're not entered into it, here is the link. In the race or in the chat? In the chat. Obviously, guys in the race can't enter, can they? You can't tell us. Jude Neville on the back of Thierry. Actually, he dropped off just a little bit there. Ben Averod's up into the top 10, ladies and gentlemen. Back up into the top 10 positions. There's only 2 years? Okay, 3 years. Okay. I was expecting more. We got around about 50 viewers. But I was expecting at least 10% of you being here be racing that. Who wants to race it but can't either find a team or doesn't have the license class yet? Shy people? I'm not on about, like, don't get involved in a chat. I mean, it's more, I wondered how many people are actually signed up to race it. A lot in the race? Well, we know that, yeah, we know that. I want to race, but my team decided they want to be shit. Family plans and a license here. Fair enough. You'll be racing with the other Aston gang members. Stu's racing it. Now, I've heard Stu race a lot of races and he doesn't actually turn up to them. So we'll find that one out when you actually race it, Stu. You're in Rebston. I have a baby to look after, so not me. But Martin gang better, yo. That's a point. There is a lot of switching and moving going on in mid-grid because currently everyone is pitting. It's that halfway point. It's nearly halfway to the end of the season. It's like 30 minutes and the season ends. In 30 minutes time, my season ends. That's mental. In 30 minutes time, only 30 minutes time away. That's actually crazy. Cool. You've done 3 pit school races over the last few weeks. Wow. I think that's more than I've done this season, to be fair. I don't know how many races I've done this season. Someone can tell me. Busso coming into the pits as well. Pirello's in the pits. Ben Averod's managed to climb it back up into 5th place position. Obviously, he still has to pit. Reese Tattersall in 1st. Ben Averod and Reese are still 37 seconds apart. Okay, so there's quite a few of you actually driving the 6 hours of Wimbledon. You won the weekend, Roya? Nah. Oh, the actual race or the whole series? Because you can't be the race, surely. Just an FYI, if you are entered into the giveaway, you do actually have to provide me your email address. It's the only way they can put the invite onto your account. So if you're entered into the giveaway, just remember that. Just remember that. And you will have to be here at the end of the stream. Just an FYI. Yeah, Felix currently in second, coming into the pits. He's going to be seeing if he can come out ahead. Rebston staying out still. Remember that the undercut is probably one of the better ways to actually gain positions in this race. Ben Lopard in 22nd. Well, I would have said one of the better ways, but we've seen that many position changes in the last few minutes that it's anybody's game now. It is literally anybody's race. All that Reese Tattersall has to do is just not bin it for another 30 minutes. Really? And it could possibly be his championship. I mean, I know we have all the penalties to apply and all that kind of stuff. Possibly, if there is any, at the end of the stream. But currently, Reese Tattersall, first place position. Ben Averrod in fourth, 37 seconds behind the leader. Aston Gang with the SG30. You gotta remember, there is no stewards in this. So to lay it down. It's the end of the season. I can say the truth. You know me. I don't mince my words, guys. Why y'all love me, right? Hopefully. Oh, you hate me. You are. The reason that we don't have live stewards is because, to be honest, by the end of it all. You know, if you do live stewarding and you apply a point and then someone goes, well, actually, no, I didn't really care, or it affected my race, or actually, I want to protest it, you know, that kind of stuff. And then you've got the whole, or actually, should that penalty been a penalty? Well, we only had an hour to decide and all that kind of stuff. And then we had 40 more incidents. It was easier to just go, you know what? Let the drivers decide when they want to report people. And then we already have the protesting system in place for literally 90% of the penalties anyways. So they can decide whether it's a worthy penalty or not. And if it isn't, then the stewards will look at it anyways. And then they'll get a week to decide. So it's a bit better than live stewarding, really. It's not like, ha, you get a 10-second penalty. And then they go, oh, well, actually, you've ruined my race from that because now I've pitted in the wrong place. So, yeah. And the fact that you have to go through all the licensing requirements to get into this race to begin with, it's just, yeah, you know what I mean? It'll sort itself out. When we figured it all out, live stewarding's nice to have, but it doesn't, like, what does it add? It knocks five people's day out to steward it when we could have 20 stewards look at the race instead. You know, it just limits your potential. Anyways, talking about limiting potential, Felix is currently in third, nearly getting overtaken by Thomas Perello. Perello all over the back of him. Felix gets a little bit of wiggle, runs off track, and possibly, yes, Perello gets by, and so does Pollock. Felix is now down into fifth place position, and Rebston's right on his back as well. Rebston in get 20 live stewards, and can all debate over the incidents. In an hour, by the time everyone's like debated over him, you know. I mean, the point of the matter is, you can, yeah, well, the point of live stewarding is to ensure safety on track, right? Not like as in safe people's lives. And it's a video game. You know what I mean? Like, we can put yellow flags out, we can put safety cars out and stuff like that. But you don't have anything to really clear. Like, what are you clearing? Press escape and click return to garage if you're in a bad spot. You know what I mean? You're not really adding much. If anything, it's not really helping. I think I get it's great. I really, really do get it's great to simulate real racing, right? It's great to simulate it all. But at the end of the day, virtual racing and real racing, they're completely different breeds. And I mean, if anyone goes on a massive rampage, they'll soon get reported and soon get banned. So, you know what I mean. So, at the end of the day, it solves itself. Bulldog! Man, Man, your support on this stream has just been unreal. 37 gifted subs. He's got the cheering leaderboard. This man is... Thank you. I don't even know what to say. It's just like the amount of support for the stream and the community. Oh, Fish is not facing the right way here. Fish is not doing great here. Okay, he's got himself. He's decided that, yeah, probably best to release and come back. That's good. But yeah, Rebston in the top five fight here. What a fantastic job by Rebston. Remember, wild card entry. He's only coming in. I think he's only doing it because of the 6 hours of Imola. He's coming up. But yeah, Rebston was live steward, right? Casper was a live steward. So that's two cars that wouldn't be on this grid. Rebston live steward, Casper a live steward. Andy live steward, but he's playing iRacing all the time. So that would have been free, you know, and I mean, fair, Casper's not had a great run today, but he qualified in the top 10. You know what I mean? Rebston is in the top 10 right now. So you're missing out on like three good cars that could be good, giving good battling. So you're not really gaining much for it. And then if they're not involved in the fight and the penalty that's getting protested or getting sent to the stewards doesn't actually affect their technical race, you know, then they can decide on the penalties anyways. So, you know, at the end of the day, they're still getting to do it anyways. But Felix looking around the outside of Barley here. Barley gets a little bit of slide, but here they go, dancing to and fro. And Felix on the inside line here. They're almost rubbing. I think there might have been a little bit of a rub here. But now Felix and Pawlik battling it out, and Rebston kind of has the best view. He can't really see ahead of Felix right now because he's all over the back of that Porsche, and that Porsche is holding him out well. But that kind of shows just how big and how wide the Aston Martin is, because when the Aston Martin is right behind the Porsche, contact between the two. Pawlik's off, Felix is off, and it's almost like Rebston just parted the ways. Rebston didn't even have to do anything. He just waited. Just waited for the contact, the inevitable contact that was going to happen between the two. And Rebston is now up into third place position. And only two seconds behind Pirello. Has to get through the few backmarkers that are ahead. That's Slurink and Svoboda ahead. 36th and 35th who are battling it out here. But this is Rebston up in third place position. Do you want to know the interesting thing? So Rebston actually said, I'm not sure whether I should go and drive this race. He wanted to, but I was like, you know what? It's a series. Sign up for it. I mean, at the end of the day, as long as you don't take, as long as you don't take anyone out, you're fine. I mean, if you do take someone out, you're probably going to live without them the rest of your head for the rest of your life. But it's virtual racing. There's no money on the line. Busso on the back of Fisher here. Let's see if Busso can get himself up into open in sixth place. Switch to the number 71 driver. Back to Scotland we go. Freedom! As long as you don't take Ben out. Yeah, well, I think Ben got taken out by Luke, didn't he? Serbian Scotland? Yeah, I know, right? Well, the funny thing is, I got the country codes off of the ACC wiki. It's wrong. It is wrong. It is well wrong. It is well wrong. Thanks for the sub there. Another gifted sub. Man. It's because of ACC Wiki. That's why. I got the country codes off there. They're wrong. Tad's had a bit of an off. Oh, Tad and Svoboda have had a contact by the looks of it. Svoboda's facing the wrong way. Tad is going to be away with that. Not entirely sure what the contact is. Where is our championship leader? Our championship leader is in 12th after pitting. This is after the pit, ladies and gentlemen. And he is currently in 12th place position. Three attempts away from Antrax. Closing down into the top 11. Fisher still has the pit. So that is one position he would gain. So currently around about 11th place position on track. Give or take. But yeah, Averod not too far behind. Ooh, hollow stickers. Hollow stickers. Oh, more hollow sticker giveaways. There we go. Beautiful. Win some hollow stickers. Exclamation mark. Enter and get yourself a hollow sticker. I would enter, but I don't want to like take one off someone. I could just buy one. All the free hollow stickers. Beautiful. Thank you there, Alessandro. Pavel Elcam. Yeah, so Ben Averod's actually dropping back from Thierry now and up into 11th for years. But Rebston is closing down the gap to Pirello. Rebston is indeed closing down that gap, and he's closing it down quickly. Let's see how quickly he is going to be getting second place position. Is this Ferrari quick enough to get himself into second? Well, here you go, Stuart Clark. Here is your limit of power where you need to get yourself into second. Well done, Will. Will won the giveaway. Congratulations, Will. Why do I call him Rebston? Because that's the name he likes to be called. And do you really want me to try and pronounce his first name? Last time I tried to pronounce him, he told me to call him Rebston. So there you go. It was that bad. It was that bad. He said, just call me Rebston. Two giveaways. That's amazing. That's amazing. I literally just opened the shop yesterday. Actually, we literally just opened the shop today. Ooh, Rebston. Having a little bit of an off there. Yeah, it used to be his team name. Is it not Pavel? I don't know. That's why I thought it. He just lost it to Frederick, to Pollock. What about Fredrickson? What, Tyre? Oh, that one's easy. I thought it was Pavel as well, yeah. So I thought W's were always V's, but the L has got like a slash for it. So it might be like Pavel or something like that. I don't know. I don't know what it is. I don't know. Ask him. Ask him in Discord if he's racing. Ben Averod looking to get into ninth. I made him spin. It's because I said that he was your level that you had to drive to, Stu. That's why it was. That's exactly what that was. I'm just watching like how many people get Twitch subscriber role in Discord now. It's like Ben Averod is closing down the gap to Thierry in the number 46 Lexus though, and that is not Thierry Henry. It is Andre Thierry. Okay, and yes, Ben Averod is closing down that gap. Will be challenging for ninth place position possibly. Remember, he's the lowest finishing position. That is where he's actually finished, not just like generally. What in this championship, I believe, was third place. Are you sure he heard he is that joke all the time? He probably does, yeah. No, it's because Mr. Simquips himself said Thierry Henry. Ben Averod's worst position is actually third. Currently in 10th. Possibly this could be his worst finishing position. But we're going to find out. We're going to find out, aren't we? We are going to find out. I know you heard that joke in the States as well for having the last name. His finish technically doesn't matter, no. But if first place for Reese Tattersall is more points than Ben Averod's third place... with the extra points that he needs around about 36 points. So Reese needs 36 more points than Ben Averod's worst finish, which was 297. So Reese needs, with a win, wow, he might actually win this championship with this win. There's a good possibility that he will win this championship with this win. A very good possibility. Because the difference between third and first is around about 50 points, give or take. So technically, Averod needs to come second. Averod needs to get it back into second in 16 minutes. He's got 8 positions to gain in 16 minutes. Oh, wow. This, I've just realized how much does pit skill get? I think it's like 10%, 5%. Usually around about 5% margins. I think we set him to like about 5% margins. Okay, Polish girlfriend, tell me how to pronounce his name. And yeah, I don't blame y'all for calling him Refston. Yeah. Yeah, since Sergi isn't in this race, it might be a little bit lower. It depends how many people are at the top end. Oh, Thierry has just had a yellow flag. And Ben Averon's just got himself up into ninth. But now Refston is on the back of Alexander. And going to be looking down to try and get third place. Basically, the more expensive the item is, the more percent we get back from the merch. It's kind of how it works, technically, because there's more margins. But for stickers, I think they're pretty much around about 5% or something like that. It's not massive amounts. I'm not going to lie. But they're cool, right? They're cool. It would be a lot cheaper if someone just printed like 500 stickers and just sold them all for us, but you know, whatever. Well, let's find out if Refston can find a pass on to Pawlik. Here we go. Felix is actually closing down on this fight, because there is Felix in the Aston making a comeback. Here comes Felix in fifth place position, and look at this. He is closing down onto that. Onto that Ferrari at a rate of knots. Oh, so the first name is Pavel? Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Not gonna. Yeah. It's like. It's not like that. That's probably absolutely butchered it. But I know, like, S. Is it CZ? Is like a ch sound? I don't know. I can't. But yeah, here is Refston looking to hold on to fourth. Possibly get it in the third. Felix is battling him down to him. And with the live stewards, it's the E that changed it. Ah, right, okay. I love Polish names because hardly anyone can pronounce them. It's great. Like, you get, like, Germanic names and you're like, all right, I can give it a shot. But you see a Polish name, you're like, yeah, that's Polish. I'm not going to even try. I do not want to make myself look like an idiot. Felix not looking like an idiot, though. He's looking to try and get himself into fourth, trying to get that position back. Doesn't want to lose out on those points that he nearly got. Doesn't want to lose out on those points that people have predicted on him at the start of the stream either. Look at them points that are currently assigned to Reese Satisol. If Reese Satisol wins this, 15k points are on the line. 3.9k points are on the line for Felix. And 2.1k are on the line for Ben Averon. Well, Ben Averon's down in ninth. Reese Tattersall up in third. Refston in fourth. Felix needs to try and claw back 15 seconds here. Felix needs to claw back 15 seconds, but you can see Bjorn just on the background there in a little bit of a yellow flag situation. Felix getting himself past nine. Ooh, nearly past neutral. He had a bit of a slide in the Aston Martin. He's got it in drift mode. Aston Martin's gonna be drift mode. Who knows? I doubt it. The Ford Focuses do, don't they? Why does a Ford Focus come with a drift mode? I have no idea. But yes, Refston still looking for a way past Paul. It can't find that way up into third place. Will it only be fourth for Refston, or will he be able to pick up a third place position? Once that third place position on his license starts, I think. Oh, apparently, the stickers are probably one of the better items to buy. Buy stickers. 10 out of 10, buy stickers. Buy lots of stickers. If you want to support the pit crew, pit skill in the best way with merch, buy stickers. Apparently. I mean, like, six stickers, which is probably about as much as a hoodie is. Six stickers is better in profit margins than it is to get a hoodie. So there you go. Buy stickers and... Isn't my wife... My wife isn't Polish. My wife's Indian. Rebston right on the back of Pollock here, as he has been for the last around about 5-10 minutes. Can't find a pass on that Porsche yet. This might be it though. Around the outside, he's forced onto the grass. Will not be wanting to break out there. Couldn't get himself back on the track. Oh no, contact between the two. And Pollock is now spun around. Well, had a little bit of a rub. And Rebston up into third. Felix now in fourth place position. Ooh, that's spicy. That is very spicy. Now, someone could say that Pollock should have let him back onto the track, and Rebston also should have brought better. But well, if the reports come in, the reports will happen, and it'll sort it out. At least we don't have to sort it out. But yes, Busso is catching up to this train as well. Rebston is not looking at finishing fifth, is he? He's really not looking at finishing fifth at all. He's like, I need to lose this pack. Felix is now right on the back of me. I got past him once. Do not want to lose out in the next 9 minutes. And the battle is now happening between Felix, Rebston, and Pollock for third place position. This is podium battling. This is podium battling here. Let's see if Felix can get this position back from Rebston. Remember, Rebston took it from Felix to begin with. He now wants it back. And three attempts away from Rebston currently. Tad has Jude Neville to contend with. Jude Neville looking to go around the outside. Might get the switch back going though. And foot down. And Tad's got the big pit skill on his wing. Will it help him get the downforce down the straight? Ben Avrod in this battle as well. Ben Avrod, the championship current holder. Right on the back of Jude Neville. I just realized we've got to wait until... Wow, we've got to wait until this race is finished to find out who the provisional winner is, because we have to wait for the points to score. So we'll have to find that out when we do the giveaway. So stick around at the end of the race to find out who the provisional championship winner is. But this is all going down. It's all going down here. Ben Avrod trying to find a bit of time, a bit of points back from that early loss. Doesn't also want to lose a bunch of pit skill. Also doesn't want to lose a bunch of pit skill. Reese Tattersall, fastest lap, just put another one in. 140.594. Sorry about that. 140.594 from Reese Tattersall there. I just realized that the sim hub overlays weren't working. There you go. Now you can see Ben Avrod's actual pit skill. But yeah, Reese Tattersall, fastest lap of the race so far, 140.595. Ben Avrod trying to get his way back up the grid in ninth. Started, what was it, second, dropped down to 25th. He's now back up in ninth place position. Got some good points back, to be fair. Luckily, he's got two drop rounds, but he's going to be looking to make sure he gets past Jude Neville here. Yes, he does, on the inside line. He's now on the back of Tad. Can he find a way past Tad, or is he going to be stuck behind that McLaren? And no, he makes short work of that and up into seventh place position. Two positions, two corners, done, dusted. Jude Neville looking to get himself involved in that position, gaining no, and Tad just being able to defend that one off. But wow, fantastic, fantastic racing from Ben Avrod. Yeah, Reese Felix, and then actually, it might have been Reese Felix Ben. Maybe? Oh, yeah. No, yeah, you're right. Yeah. Because it was Reese Felix, someone else. Who was someone else? Who else was it? I'm sorry, fourth person. It wasn't Rebston, was it? No, it wasn't Rebston. I don't know. I don't know. Was it Pirello? Oh, yeah, Pirello. Sorry, Pirello. Pirello's sat in second. He's like, am I invisible? Am I invisible right now, guys? Come on. It was Aston's. It was the Aston front field. Am I invisible to you right now? Sorry, guys. So, yes, there you go. That's Avrod, to be fair. Considering he started, I could just look. He started fourth, down in the seventh. He's not lost that many positions from where he qualified, to be fair. To be fair, he did have a great comeback. You've got to give it to him. Down in the seventh, qualified fourth. Might not be the greatest of races for him. He does have that third place position, but he did lose a lot on the first lap. And as you say, he span around. He did have that spin coming out of the chicane. So, you know, quite a lot of positions gained back for Ben Avrod. And a lot of points on there as well. Speaking of points, Jude Neville looking to claim some from Tad right now as we come over the crest. Can we get some biggest ups and downs? Of course you can. Of course you can. So, the biggest up is currently Callum Scotland, up 15 positions from where he started. Started 29th on the grid, up into 15th place position. Luke Tranmere, dropping. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm literally just about to click that button. There you go. Hashtag driver number for your driver of the day. Luke Tranmere dropping 15 positions from 5th. Biggest loss so far today. Sorry, Casper. Biggest loss. Actually, I think possibly Balazs might be beating him. But Balazs isn't in the race anymore. Casper losing 25 positions. Down into 33rd. Started 8th place. Svoboda dropping 19 positions. And who else has gained? Oh, Pirello has picked up a drive-through. That's going to be massive. Rebston might get second. Rebston might get second, but Felix is looking to make sure it isn't going to be. Felix is looking to close down that gap. Who is going to be your driver today? Hashtag driver number. Only your first vote counts, and you can only vote once. Thank you for the new follow. How many follows are we on? We're nearly like 5k yet. What are we on? Oh, no. I don't know where we are. How many? What? We are 4 subscribers away from 100 subscribers. We are nearly at 2.5k subs, follows. That's mental. I'm just looking here. 96 subscribers. We're nearly 100 subscribers and nearly 2.5k followers. That's crazy. That is crazy. Felix with a drive-through. Oh, no. Felix with a drive-through. Well, that's 2 out. Ben is going to get himself up into 5th from just doing that. That is crazy. Oh, okay. Now we've got... Okay. Oh, there we go. 101 subscribers. Thank you, guys. Thank you. 100 subscribers. What a way to end the season. What a way to end the season. And considering Nords is coming next week, that is mental. Remember, guys, we do have the Nordschleife series starting up on the day of release. Day of release starts the Nord series. So if you want to get involved in the Nordschleife series, you can get yourself involved in that by signing up. You will need to get C-Class before it comes out. It comes out on Monday. There's also a US series, but the US series actually has the ranking and the pit rep enabled. So if you want to get involved in a competitive US series, it doesn't require any sort of license class. You can join that as a rookie. So you want to get involved in some late night Nordschleife if you're an EU driver, or if you are a US driver and you want to get involved in some competitive Nordschleife, get yourself involved in that. That will be running every other day as well. So Nordschleife for rookies. Yeah, that's right. Nordschleife for rookies. I think it's got, I can't remember what classes it's got in it. I'm sure someone can tell me. GT3 and GT4. GT3 and GT4. Right, back to this championship. Felix is spun. Felix is spun. How did Felix spin? That's mental. That is crazy. What is going on? What is going on at the end of this series? I have no idea. But I'll tell you, some man who does have an idea, and that's Reese Tatsall. He is about to take the win. Jude Neville's off as well. Jude Neville is off in the 128 AMG. Wow, this is all heating up at the back of the season. The final race of the season. This is absolutely mental. This is mental. So yeah, it looks like the number 71 is going to be winning the driver of the day. That is Callum Scotland, unless the votes change dramatically very, very shortly. However, the man, the myth, the legend, Reese Tattersall, might be possibly winning the championship with this win. With this win, he could take the championship away from Ben Averod. With this singular win, that's all he needed. Will it be enough? We're going to find out very, very, very shortly as Reese Tattersall crosses the line, taking home the win at Imola for round 10. And there we go. Reese Tattersall first. Thomas Perello, 12 seconds behind, has a drive through. So he's going to pick up a 90 second time penalty. And, yeah, that's a... Oh, no, it's a 30-second time. That's not that bad, then. Rebston across the line in third in the end. Pollock in fourth. Fifth goes to Busso. Sixth is possibly going to be Ben Averod. Yes, it is. Sixth goes to Ben Averod in the number 29. Will it be enough to keep him in for the win? We're going to find out when the points are passed. We do have the giveaway. We also have... What else do we have? Ah, we'll have some stuff. It'll be fine. Thierry crossing the line in seventh. Eighth to Tadeusz. Ninth to Taye. Tenth to Antrax. Law to 11th. Jude Neville in 12th place position. Callum Scotland picking up the driver of the day. Number 71 picking up the driver of the day vote. Congratulations to Callum Scotland in the Serbian Scotland car, as some people like to call it. But it is Reese Tattersall doing the donuts and winning the race and possibly the championship. We're going to have to wait until all the points have been calculated. And it's going to be very, very interesting to find out what these points are going to display when this race ends. What an amazing race, guys. That was absolutely amazing. And you got to remember that, yes, as Andy said, there might be some penalties up and down the grid. I'm not sure it will change the front running, though. I don't think Reese was in any contentious moves, was he? I'm not 100% sure. But yes, Reese right at the front of the grid. It might knock Ben Averod up, possibly. Who knows? Who knows? I think Reese is pretty safe, though. I don't think there was any dodgy contact between Reese and yes, unless there was a dodgy contact with Felix. But we're gonna have to find out. We're gonna have to find out whether indeed Reese wins the series. Tell you what, we'll do the giveaway whilst we're waiting. So I'll leave that open for another couple of minutes. It's !! giveaway to find out how to enter that, or !! ticket, and you can buy your tickets for the giveaway. Subs get 2x chance, just to say a thank you, basically. And there is 4 months of Go Setup subscriptions to give away. So you want to get yourself involved in that. All you have to do is buy some tickets. I'll leave that open until around about 2 minutes. So 20:47 on my clock, so 2 minutes time. And that will have been open for 1:25. Should do a merch giveaway? Can I do a merch giveaway? I don't actually know what I'm doing. Can I do a merch giveaway? Let me find out. I don't know if I could do my own merch giveaway. I don't know if that's a thing. Products. Just buy it myself. Yeah, no, that's what I'm trying to find out. Replay of top moves. We can do that. Give me a sec. Give me a sec. We need to do the We need to actually show the winner of the race. It was restart us all, so points are going to be getting handed out for that. Don't worry, I will be right back. I don't have an intermission stream, but here we go. Okay. I can buy me on stickers. Giveaway. Okay. Yeah, I know. Whoa. Jesus. I was about to give stickers away, and then I saw the postage price, and I was like, what? Basically, for each one, you pay postage. And I was like, wow, that's crazy. Yes, Scottish, you won driver of the day. Congratulations. Since everyone is in the Twitch chat right now, I'll give a sticker away as well. Let's all give stickers away. Stickers away are fun, right? Here you go. Your payment is being processed. It's coming. It's coming, guys. It's coming. There you go. Apparently it says anonymous, but it was from me. There you go. There you go. You can get yourself involved in the giveaway. Full holo sticker. We've just launched the merch store. So if you want to actually get some actual merch and you don't want to be involved in the giveaway, you can do that by entering. You can click on the merch link and get yourself some merch. It's just gone live just today, actually. But you can get yourself involved in the giveaway for a sticker, an actual holographic sticker, proper real life sticker there. Get yourself involved in that by literally entering. And we also have the subs to give away. We also have the subscriptions to the you'll pick one up for the rig. Good man. So anyone that bets on Restatsol today for the predictions, congratulations, you just got some points. I go, congratulations to Cappy Jack for the holo sticker. Congratulations, dude. And let's do the draw of the 10 seconds. You got 30 seconds to enter into the giveaway. It's ticket one, or ticket two, ticket three, ticket four, however many tickets you want to buy. You got around about 30 seconds to do so. And when that is closed, you can no longer get any of those Go Settles monthly subscriptions. So get yourself involved in the chat, get yourself some entries into that giveaway. But wow, the amount of points that were on offer for that race. Exclamation mark ticket, and then however many tickets you want to buy. Exclamation mark ticket. And you had around about 10 seconds to go. It might be tickets. Is it ticket or tickets? I don't know. I'm sure it's ticket. You might not have enough points to be able to do tickets, to be honest. I would just do one. Exclamation mark ticket one. Because everyone gets their first ticket for free. So you haven't already got one, then yeah. You can enter view via that link as well. If you just click that link and then just type in how many tickets you want to buy, you can do it that way. And then that will be the end of the season once these have been given away. I think it's like 20 points a ticket, but it comes from Stream Elements points. It isn't the points on the actual channel. It's not the point on the actual channel. It is the Stream Elements points. There's 858 tickets purchased. 858 tickets. That is crazy. But I think it's time. I think it's time to close the giveaway for the Go setups. Let's find out. Wow, there's a lot of tickets up and down that grid. Let's close it then. 872 tickets, and in 10 seconds, it will have been open for an hour and a half. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Closed. Right then, let's draw some winners. We have 4 Go setups subscriptions to give away. So the first one goes to Alex. The first one is stupidly misguided. I've just realized that you can't actually see it, can you? That's a bad effort, isn't it? Don't worry, there's four. There's 4, and if you're in the race, if you were in the race, you do actually get chance to go into that. There we go. Now you can see it, right? So that's 1. It's not rigged. Promise. It is not rigged. right. That's 1. We'll need your email address. So just message me on Twitch. It'll be easier. Then I can match your Twitch names up. That's 1. Ready? 2. That's 2. Casper's the second. Right, let's get the third. Third is Andy. Oh my god. Third is Andy. Right, who's going to be the 4th? All right, okay, that's fine. I mean, Don just did like 25 subs away, so there you go. They are all four of the entrants. If you just want to DM me your actual email address, and that's you. Congratulations everyone. In all chat? All right, okay. Yes, I will email Go Setups over. But yeah, you can see there, 872 tickets purchased. And yeah, congratulations to... Was this? No, it doesn't show up on my screen. Okay, good. And yes, if you would like to get yourself involved in the merch, you'd like to get yourself involved in some merch, you can check on the merch store there. Are you going to just go over our website, pitskill.io, and there's a new merch thing on the banner. Thank you to all of the people that entered it. And yes, as you say, we will have to wait to see if Reese has won the championship. Just waiting around to find that out. Don't worry, not too long to go now. It's just right in the entrance. You're off to make a sticker. Can't believe you would rig it like this. quite simply, next season, remember to do it, because the more entries you have into it, the more chance you have of winning. Because basically, what options I get like look like this, right? So I can see how many winners have done what, right? Okay. And you can set the ticket cost, and you can set the maximum amount of tickets per person. And then you can set how much subscriber you have, right? So I tick this, and then you find out. And then you can get the tickets for free. And then that percentage chance that you saw was how many, was how much percent based on, so Andy had a 21%. How much did Don have? Oh, I didn't say Don's. That's sad. Okay. Didn't say Don's. And he didn't say Alex's. But yeah, there you go. There you go. I don't know how much Alex had. Can I see it? Can I see it? How do I see it? No, I don't want to. No. Don't know how to see it. I don't want to. Ah, there we go. Oh, no, I didn't want to reopen it. No. Okay. Yeah, so if Don can just DM me. I'm sure Don will, like, finish me up. So I've got Andy's, I've got Alex's, I've got Casper's. Let's mark it as complete. And it should tell me what percent, hopefully. I'm hoping. No, I didn't. Okay. No, that's sad. But yeah, Don is probably on here somewhere. But yeah, that's basically it. So keep yourself involved in the stream. I'm watching. I am literally watching. I'm watching the score thing tick over right now. You need to code a better one? Yeah, maybe. Works fine. I'm just waiting to find out what the actual results from the race are, and then I can load them up for you. It's loading. It's done the server. And by the looks of it, I can reveal the provisional standings for the season. Are you ready, ladies and gentlemen? You ready for the drum roll? Ready for the, I don't have a drum roll. I know. I'll Google one. One second. I've got an advert on Blue YouTube now. Trust YouTube. Go accept my petition. Maybe. I don't think anyone would like that, but okay. Ready? Are you ready for the final standings of the Go Setups Trophy Challenge Season 20? It does sound like drum rolls. It is. Apparently it's drum rolls. There you go. They are the actual standings. Well, provisional, yes. Provisional standings as they stand right now. Ben Averod wins it by 22 points. And do you want to know why? It's because he attended every single round. He only got two wins. So Ben Averod only got two wins. I don't think this is mathed it right. I'll wait till Balaj definitely confirms this. But yeah, apparently that's right. Ben Averod got two wins. Oh, Reese. No, it's Reese. Reese got P5 at Nürburgring. This race didn't count for Ben Averod's race. It didn't count for Ben Averod's results. I'm just looking on the website. It did not count for Ben Averod's results. It was Reese Tattersall's Nürburgring that did it in for him. One minute. Let me get it. Reese didn't get one. No, I can't do it that way. One minute. Yeah, Reese didn't get one, so we'll have a look at the desktop. 1 minute. Desktop, desktop. One minute. Why can't I find desktop? Oh, there we go. Browser capture. Nope. Wow, this is... You're cancelling your order for confetti branding. I know, right? I know. Ah, window capture. There we go. Let me just add the right window and we... There we go. So this is the standings. As you can see here. Ignore that they're now, like, behind me. Whatever. There we go. So there you go. So Ben Averrod. Second at Suzuka, third at Silverstone, first at Nürburgring, where Reese came fifth. That's what really, really did it in for him. Because Reese didn't attend every single race. He didn't have one to drop. So even though Imola was a worse point scoring round for Ben Averrod, Reese dropped more from Nürburgring. So there you go. That is it, ladies and gentlemen. That is why Reese has just lost out in the championship. 20 points he lost out on. And realistically, he only really needs to attend Suzuka to be able to get him, probably, and finish higher than fifth. So yeah, massive, massive upset in the championship. But that just tells you everything, that, doesn't it? That just tells you literally everything you need to know. That is absolutely crazy. Right then, is anyone still streaming? That's just us. All right, okay. Well, thank you all for coming along. Get yourself involved in some daily races now, and I will see you. I think Sergi said it was mathematically impossible. Apparently, that's what Sergi said. That's what Sergi said himself. I didn't want to question his maths. I didn't want to question his maths, but that is it. That is it for season 20. Season 21 will be announced tomorrow to all you non-patrons. If you are a Patreon, you will already know what season 21 is bringing. And if you are also a Patreon, you'll also know all about what's coming up next week. You'll be able to sign up for them Nords races as well. They will open 2 days before the race for everyone else. Thank you all again for coming along. Thanks for all the support this season. Thanks for, you know, the gifted merch, the gifted subs, the bits, the follows, all of the support. We will be back next season. Again, it'll be a 2-week break, and then we'll be back racing for the championship. Remember, it's a full 2-week break before the next championship. It is a full 2-week break for the next championship. So we will see you for the first round. And if you are in the Discord, you will get a notification what that championship round is next. Tomorrow. Yeah, tomorrow it will go live. Thank you all for coming along. Honestly, I couldn't do it without you. Without you guys in the chat every week, it would get a little bit lonely. Right at the start of the season, like right at the start of Pitskill, it was a lot like that. And in the last few weeks, it's been absolutely massive. And I couldn't thank all of you enough, honestly. It's been a rough few months for me, but, you know, we pulled through. We're all here together. And honestly, without you guys in the chat every week, then it would be a lot more difficult. I can say that much. But yeah, thank you all for coming along, like I said, and see you all again next season. Peace out.